gonna go ahead and turn that down. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you all for coming out today. And on behalf of everyone here, I would like to thank you all for coming to BBC Equestria Studios. Now let's get a show of hooves here, or hands. I forget that we have humans here now. How many of you, this is your first time in a television studio? Let's get a show of hands. All right, so we have some veterans here. Either that or they don't want to answer. All right, well, don't worry. For those of you, if you're either a veteran or you're just now coming to the studio, we'd like to welcome you all. We do have a couple of rules and regulations to go over before we officially go live, because as you can see, our little camera back there, folks, you see it says BBC Equestria. That's because at 10:30, we'll be broadcasting live on BBC Equestria. So yeah, pretty fun. So what we're gonna do now, we're just gonna go through the quick rules and regulations of the studios. So first off, please make sure your cell phones and other electronic devices are either turned off or silenced. So that way our game show is not interrupted by your ringtone of "Let me take a selfie." And also, be sure that you have the flash function on your camera turned off. Self-explanatory, the flash is blinding and it's annoying and I don't like it. And of course, you can actually record this show if you want, like if one of your friends is chosen as a contestant, and we'll get into that selection process in a little bit. But if you want to film it, please make sure you do not block the view of others with your camera, so don't like hold your camera up like this and be filming it like that. But of course, you can just watch it on Ponyville Live later. And next up, we do ask that all unicorns, please limit your magic to short-range levitation, because we have recently found out that any other types of magic do cause interference with our audio and video recording equipment. Basically, the screen goes fuzzy and the audio sounds really warped. And we actually had a test of that a couple of weeks ago, and when we looked at the final product, my voice was really deep like this, and it sounded really weird and awful, and no one liked it. And also, if we have any Pegasi here, we would like to ask that you do not fly while you are in the studio. We do have some, there is risk of injury and equipment damage. We have some, had some equipment here. I don't know where it went. It seems like the only thing we have here is this box. I don't know what it's used for, but anyways. Okay, now we get to our favorite part, the contestant selection. So what I want y'all to do right now is take a look under your seats. If you have something that says game ticket, then come on up here towards the front of the stage, and you will be our contestants. Do we have anything? It sounds like ripping paper. I think someone, if we have someone with a game ticket, come on up. We got one! And we...
Throw off the bottom of a chair.
Hold on. Hold on, what's going on? Wait, I don't think anyone else was sitting in that other seat.
I think what he meant was everyone looked under the seats to see if it
was... Yep, here it is.
I'm closest.
I've got the Euro winner tag.
There you go.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Aww.
Alright, so let me get back up here. So ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our two contestants. Nope, hold on, I did not have to music that. Let's give it up for our two contestants. Okay, that's not the right, that's Equestrian Idol. It's different. Okay, so you two, if you would like to have a seat right there on the front row, those are your reserved seats. And folks, we're going to be getting started in just a few moments, so to get yourselves ready, please make sure that you take your seats at this time. Good. And just stay there. I'm going to talk with these guys for a moment, and we'll get started here very shortly. Oh yes, we have to do this. It's a requirement. My Little Millionaire is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial 4.0 International License, blah blah blah. My Little Millionaire is a parody version of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. The show is not meant to infringe upon any copyrights. Please support the official release. And now, you just get to stare at that screen until it's time. So you'll hear a stage manager come on. Oh, one more thing. When we do actually start, you're going to see the screen will say, please remain very quiet, and then there will be like a countdown to applause, because that's when we'll want you all to start applauding for the title sequence. So, we're just about ready here, I think.
Stand by.
Oh, here we go, here we go.
All right, audience, we need absolute quiet. We are live in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
them on television every day. Ordinary people testing their luck, their knowledge, even their singing skills. Game shows have a unique property about them that keeps you wondering what will happen next. You forge a bond with the contestant and hope that they win. My mission is to bring the excitement of a game show straight to you by taking you out of your living room and putting you in the middle of the action. Today, two bronies just like you were selected to take part in the greatest experience of their weekend. They will test their knowledge on everything to do with My Little Pony, seeing if they can make it to the top. But how far will they be able to get? There's only one way to find out. Live from Brony Fan Fair in Austin, Texas, welcome to My Little Millionaire! This is pretty cool. All right, let's go and cut the music. Trust me, folks, when you're working on a show for over a year and a half, that song does get a little annoying. So anyways, we'd like to welcome everyone watching either on BBC Equestria or Ponyville Live. Thank you all for tuning in, and welcome to My Little Millionaire. This is a Brony game show that has been going on for over a year and a half. And basically, you all know how it works. If you've seen Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, like the older version, where the contestants were actually sitting in a hot seat and the show made sense. But basically, our contestants will be presented with 15 multiple choice questions, and they will be asking you for their help occasionally, but they will ultimately be competing for this, the grand prize. That's right, folks. It is a copy of The Journal of the Two Sisters, written by Amy Keating Rogers and published by Little Brown and Company. But we're not there yet. First, we've got to go through all this. So, once again, as I have said, we have selected our two contestants today, and it's time to bring up the first one. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome... What was it again? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Madam Manga May. Welcome. So let's get some info out of you first. If you want to take that off the stand, you can.
Okay.
All right. So is this your first Brony convention?
Yes, actually, it's my first convention ever. I've never actually been to a convention before, but my girlfriend and dad have. So.
Yep, there they are out in the audience. It's too bad we can't show an audience camera to show them, but whatever. So how much do you think you know about My Little Pony?
Pretty good amount of knowledge, though. I think the other guy's probably
going to
win,
though.
But
don't think like that. Okay, but anyways, so as I've said before, you will be presented with 15 multiple choice questions. You can see them on this screen. Everyone else will see them on this screen here. But they will be getting harder as you go along, but don't worry, you do have three lifelines to help you out, and they are... phone or Skype contact, 50-50, or ask the audience. That last one is pretty obvious because we have an audience here and we're going to ask them. So, basically just choose the right answer, and if you're correct, you move on. We have three levels of prizes. You can see them back there. And if you get past the first five questions, you get one of them. If you get past the first 10 questions, you get the second prize. And if you get past all 15 questions, you get the grand prize, and I get to open up and empty out this box of confetti. Yep. Oh, by the way, folks, fun fact, this is actually from Disney World, so you know it's good. All right, so are you ready to get started?
Okay,
audience, are you ready? All right, well, here we go. Four, and I do have to say, it will show dollar amounts, but I don't have $1 million just lying around, so they'll be playing for prizes instead, but here we go. For 100 bits, here's your first question. That is loud. This one is a Fancyman question from Flutterkind. Here we go. How many ponies are in the main six? A, 3.5. Yeah, you have to wait for me to read out the answers. A, 3.5. B, 6. C, 7. Or D, 517 2/3.
I'll go with B.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
Well, it's pretty obvious that you're right. Yeah, there you go. That's what you're supposed to do. When you get it right, then you applaud. Good, I got that right with the music. Okay, so you ready to keep going? Pretty easy so far, yeah? You're on your way to that first prize. Okay, here we go. For 200 bits, here's your next question. Another one from Flutterkind. I didn't even introduce myself. My name is Kyler Holder, and I'm the host of My Little Millionaire. Pleased to meet you. Thank you. Let's try this again. For 200 bits, here's your next question. Another one from Flutterkind. There's going to be a lot from Flutterkind this episode. He likes to send in questions. All right. What did she send? Oh, this is my favorite one. What did she sandwich name his rubber chicken? A, boneless. B, floppy. C, Cheese Jr., here it comes. Or D, Sir Reginald Butterscott Pendragon Jr. IV.
I believe the answer is A.
Final answer? Oh, man. And then, of course, when... Oh, yeah, you got that right, by the way. And then, of course, when Cheese Sandwich gives boneless to Pinky, he would pull out Sir Reginald Butterscott Pendragon Jr. V. So, yeah, wonder what happened to the other three. So, pretty good so far. Here we go. For 300 bits, here's your next question. This one is a fascinating... Submitted by my Twilight Sparkle plush figure.
See what she has to say.
In Power Ponies, what was Pinkie Pie's superpower? Is it A, super strength, B, teleportation, C, super speed, or D, melting?
I'm going with C, super speed.
Final answer? How can she even... She has hooves. Keyboard, it doesn't work. You got it right as well. Oh yeah, imagine. And she's got that horn thingy. Yeah.
No, that's
she has wings.
Well, not this one.
No,
Alan. Yeah, this is not a princess yet. But she will be as soon as I can find a way to sew some wings on. So here we go. I believe, how much is this? Okay. For 500 bits, here's your next question. Submitted in by Trouble Notes. Hey, look, someone different. I hope that you only submitted one. Okay. What type of pony, but we just talked about this. What type of pony was Twilight Sparkle before the season 3 finale? A, an alicorn. B, a unicorn. C, a manticorn. Or D, a cob of corn.
I'll go with B.
Final answer? Our Princess Twilight, the cob of corn. And you're right as well. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Hey, okay, hold on. If any of the show writers are watching this right now, please, like, find some way to have Discord give Twilight just like a cob of corn for her horn. Yeah, I would love to see that. And if that happens, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Okay, but here we go. Oh, hey, this is the 1,000-bit question, so if you get this one right, you get the first prize.
Okay.
All right, so here we go. For 1,000 bits and the first prize, here is your next question. Submitted in to us by J.S. Josh. Here we go. In Pinkie Pride, during the goof-off, what song from the show did Cheese Sandwich parody? A, the smile song. B, at the gala. C, giggle at the ghosties. Or D, what my cutie mark is telling me.
A.
Final answer? You just got yourself a nifty little prize. Alright. So, good job on that. Just cut the song there. And no, you did not get $1,000. You see the little prize button in the corner. I have to click that because now we have to. Because now I have to describe what it is. But luckily, I pre-recorded that part. So here's what you won.
Congratulations! You've won a My Little Pony poster. Make your wall look better with ponies. This 36 by 24 inch poster contains characters seen from the past seasons of My Little Pony. This poster is an online exclusive and cannot be purchased in stores. See how many characters you can find on this poster from Hot Topic.
As you can see, I tried to do the Price is Right there with a pony theme song in the back. So folks, like any good game show, we have to take a commercial break. We'll be right back after these messages. your time and you can rest. Oh yeah, that's right. I have to do the first commercial. Okay, fun fact before we do this, have any of you seen Silver Quill's review of the Equestria Games?
Yes!
Yes!
I know where this is going.
Yep, and you're looking at the guy who did those voices. Alright, here we go.
I need to hoop on you later.
Come visit the Crystal Empire. Everything here is really shiny. I mean, really shiny. We've got royals that look nice, guards that look nice, ponies that look nice. Maybe someday they'll even have personalities. The Crystal Empire. You totally want to be here because it's sparkly. Okay, we're good. All right, folks. This is my favorite screen out of all of them. Because that means that no one can see us right now except for those watching on Ponyville Live. Hi. So basically, we've got about a minute 49 until we start the show up again. There we go. Just get the photographer in there.
I love
your Okay, so right now, other television networks are doing their own commercials. And this is what you don't see if you watch game shows. They basically sit around and just talk to each other. So, have you been enjoying the convention so far?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty fun? Yeah. Okay, so, okay, let's just take a poll here. How many of you have already wasted your money on merchandise? All right, good. Well, I am about to. Just to let you know, Mom,
yes.
My wallet is going to be coming back empty because I just saw what was inside that room there. Oh my gosh.
Gone, sorry.
Shopping spree! And let's hope. Oh, wait, here we go. And 1 minute. They add in the extra few seconds so other televisions, other networks can catch up. But, yeah. Do you know of some of them in there except like debit cards? Because I'll have to switch to that soon because I've got like $30 left.
Buy yourself a bill.
Everybody's got Square, otherwise there's an ATM in the lobby.
Okay, there's an ATM. That's good. Alright, so we've got about 30 seconds until we come back live, and at about 5 seconds I'm going to need you all to start applauding again so it seems like you all are having a good time. Okay, question. Are you having a good time so far?
Yes!
Okay, good. Good. That means I'm doing it right. So, 17 seconds. So you see the other prizes back there that you can win. Are you hoping to get to the all the way to the top?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah, but the problem is I'll have a lot of cleaning up to do if you do. Oh, hey, look at that. 5 seconds. How about we make some noise? Come on, folks. Let's hear it. Gentlemen, to My Little Millionaire, I am here with our contestant, Madame Manga May. I will never get that right. It's a good thing that this is only.
I never got my last name right. I'm by now.
It's a good thing this is only 15 questions. So you made it through the first round. You got a poster. Show them. Yeah, there you go. And if someone else makes it to that poster, if our other contestant makes it to that poster, it is unwrapped because I checked to make sure that they sent us the right posters. Okay, so yeah, you will be getting an unwrapped one. You're okay with that? All right, and I like your stack of hats as well. Very good. You can't have too many hats. So you've been through the first 5. You have not used any of your lifelines yet, so that's good. But they will be getting harder now. So are you ready to continue?
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go. Audience, are you ready to continue?
Yeah!
There you go. That's the spirit. For 2,000 bits, here is your next question. You notice the music changes as well. I'm gonna make this a little more dramatic.
I meant to do that.
Lightning strike.
Oh, no, no dramatic.
Wait, I don't think they'll be able to see. Never mind.
No, you're right.
That was all part of the plan. I'm just trying to extend this panel to fill the hour. All right, here we go. And it doesn't have anything on the bottom, so that means that I was the one that made the question. So I should know the answers. In Power Ponies, what animal did the maniac swat away that caused Fluttershy to change into Flutter Hulk? A, a dragonfly, B, a fruit bat, C, a firefly, or D, a breezy?
I'll go with A.
A, a dragonfly, final answer?
Yes.
I hate that part. Yeah, it's a firefly, but hey, I have to click this little red box now. But hey, look at that, you've got a poster. You did not get $1,000. I don't have that much money. So, well, thank you for playing. You can take your seat back down there. Ladies and gentlemen, Madame Ponyville. Alright, so I can now switch this. Oh, and in case if I do forget the answers, I've got this little baby right here. This will help me, so don't look at it. Alright, next up, we're going to go ahead and bring up our next contestant. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Fluttershy. Your microphone, if you want that. So, let's get back to the logo. That's not the logo. Where's the... What are you doing? Okay, no, they did not...
He won!
Oh my...
He won!
There. Okay, and you didn't even have to do anything. All right. So, is this your first time at a Brony convention?
No.
Oh, which other ones have you been to?
All of them. Well, all of the Brony Fan Fairs.
Really cool. Fun. Yeah, this is my first time here, so, and it looks like I know what I'm doing, when really I don't. Alright, so anyways, we're gonna have to go through the rules again. 15 multiple choice questions, you're gonna get the prizes. Hopefully I can toss some confetti at the end of this. And you will have 3 lifelines to help you out. Phone or Skype contact, 50-50, or ask the audience. Please be sure you use those. There was one episode where none of our contestants used those, and it was very disappointing. No offense, Madame Melville. All right. What she said. Okay, so are you ready to get started?
One quick thing before we start.
Yes?
Surprise! I am a changeling.
I knew it! I knew it!
Okay! Oh, look at that, you made Twilight faints. Good job.
The Royal Guard!
Hello.
Where's Celestia?
Where's Flash?
Yeah, that works. I don't know. He's probably off doing things in the Crystal Empire.
Why is he a crystal pony?
I don't know. I'm not Lord Faust. I don't have answers. Well, I have answers, but not those types of answers. Okay, so I'm guessing that now you're ready to get started.
Yes.
All right, here we go. For 100 bits, here's your first question. That's a little loud, and this one is by me, so I should know the answers to it.
Hopefully.
Where does Brony Fan Fair take place? This one's gonna be pretty easy. If you don't get this, A, Las Vegas, Nevada. B, Boston, Massachusetts. C, Honolulu, Hawaii. Oh, don't we wish, that'd be so awesome. Or D, Austin, Texas.
Now this doesn't seem very fair. I can't see it. Oh, D.
Final answer?
Yes.
If you need me to adjust the screen, I can. Yeah, you got that right, by the way. Always keep on. I mean, I trust the stage manager to switch that for me, but then I remember I don't have a stage manager.
Ah.
Yeah, this is a one-man show right here. So, pretty good so far. Here we go. I have a Twilight who can apparently submit questions with her hooves. No, magic. She has a horn. She has a cob of corn. Okay, here we go. For 200 bits, here's the next question. Another one from Flutterkind. There's a lot this time. Okay. Which one of these characters has never had a speaking role? A, Princess Luna. B, Derpy Hooves. C, Gummy. Or D, Lyra Heartstrings.
I guess I'm gonna go with Gummy.
Final answer?
Yes.
Wise choice, my son. Just out of curiosity, let's see what time it is. How much time do I have to fill? I've got to fill 45 minutes, and this is our last round. So hey, you'll be out there early, and you can explore other stuff. All right, here we go. Here we go. For what was it? Was it 300 bits? Here's your next question, and this one is like.
You're not very good at keeping track of her.
Yeah, probably not. I mean, well, I go to school every day and she stays home because if they don't allow dogs at school, they don't allow ponies at school, which is a shame. They need to change that. Hey, school board, let them in. All right, here we go. In Power Ponies, what was Fluttershy's superpower? A, turning into different animals. B, becoming Flutter Hulk, trademark Hasbro. C, turning into fruits. Or D, baking cookies. Those answers are starting to get weird.
Well, as much as the animal thing technically makes sense, I'm gonna have to go with B just to be safe.
Final answer?
Yes.
Yep, you got that right. Copyright trademark 2013 Hasbro. Not for distribution. All rights reserved. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. All right, for 500 bits, here's your next question. It's by me! Yay! Where was Cheese Sandwich living as a cult? A. Downey. B. Albuquerque. C. Manhattan. Or D. Baltimore.
I think I'm going to use my Ask the Audience on this one.
Alright, so we're going to switch to this screen here. There's our music. So, audience, he needs your help. So, now normally we would ask you to pull out the keypads in the seat in front of you, but we don't have enough money for that because of these things called budget cuts. They spent them all for filming season 5 down in Studio 7. So anyway, so we're gonna have to judge this by level of applause. So how many of you think that it's A, Downey? Okay. How many of you think it's B, Albuquerque? Okay. How many of you think it's C, Manhattan? And how many of you think it's D, Baltimore? All right, and now we have to calculate the results. If you all can't see this on stream, we're all doing this. Oh, wait, here it comes. Okay, so the audience has gone with C, Manhattan. I always have to restart the music on this. There we go. Alright, so do you agree with the audience?
Against my better judgment, I will trust them.
Okay, final answer?
Yes.
Sit up, Twilight. This is... Oh, no, it's not your question, but still. And the audience and you were correct. Alright. So, here we go. I believe this is now for 1,000 bits. Yes, and for that first prize as well. So you could be getting a poster. This time I'll be able to show it off because it's unwrapped. So here we go. For 1,000 bits, here's your next question. And... Boop. And three's a crowd. What disease did Discord pretend to have? A. The green flu. B. The purple flu. C. The swine flu. Or D. The blue flu.
That's gotta be D. The blue flu.
Final answer?
Yes.
Now, if I had more money on the show, I would be able to make it so that way, like the Ask Your Audience Life Owner had an X over it. But I can't animate that in all of this. Oh, yes, you did get it right. You got yourself an achievement prize there. So, once again, we're going to have to go to that. You've already heard the prize description. Online exclusive from Hot Topic. Not available in retail stores. Where is it? There you go. And 36 by 42 inch thing. All right, so there you go. So folks, once again, we're gonna have to take another commercial break. That's our requirement. After 5 questions, we do a commercial break. So we'll be right back after these messages. Can't hold this all day. Oh yeah, that's right, I do this one. Have you suffered a crippling injury while reviewing an episode? Perhaps you've been assaulted and turned into a bat pony, or just banished to the moon for no reason? Call attorney Habeas Corpus. He'll sue somebody and get you the money you deserve, then bill you for triple that amount. All right, so there we go. So let's learn a little bit more about you. So I actually forgot to ask where you're from.
I think that one should be obvious. Oh wait, no, it's not, because Hasbro never confirmed that.
Okay.
Cloudsdale.
Let's go with that one.
Alright, so we'll say Cloudsdale there. And I'm guessing this is your first time on a game show.
Yes.
Alright, you having a good time so far?
Yes.
Audience, you having a good time? That's good. Oh, wait, I wanted to do this whenever I got the chance, and this is a perfect opportunity. I saw Ellen do it on the Oscars, so why can't I do it?
Yeah. Everyone lean in. If you want to come in too, you can.
Okay.
Come on, we got 1 minute and 11 seconds. We can do this. Here we go. All right. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Wait, I think someone blinked.
No, it doesn't matter. Thank you.
Yeah.
Good. Up. 1 minute.
It didn't do the blinking thing.
Yeah, it did. You just weren't looking. Yeah, so,
Yeah, we do have some Skype. Those are not. There you go. We do have some Skype contacts for you to contact if you need some help. Any of them with a green dot. Looks like Cider Barrel's not online.
Oh, so it's not my Skype contacts. It's your Skype contacts.
Yeah, because I don't have that advanced technology. Budget cuts, you know? Alright, so we'll just leave that there. Alright, we got about 30 seconds. They should be in their last commercial by now. Talking about a local car dealership offering big, big, big savings on small, small, small cars. And a summer promo giveaway, the third. Win a trip to Alaska or something. Oh, hey, look at that. 10 seconds. Hold on, you don't start clapping until 5, so that way you can save up your energy and stuff. Oh, hey, look, 5 seconds. There we go. 3, 2, 1. Back to My Little Millionaire. I have a contestant that changed Fluttershy here. And,
Jim, just messing with you.
Okay. Of course. All right, so we're going to keep on going. You've already gotten the poster, and you are a third of the way through. So that's good, and he's only had to use Ask the Audience. So he's got the two lifelines left. So here we go. For 2000. Oh, are you ready?
Yes.
And are you ready?
Yes!
And is our live stream audience ready?
Yes.
Yes, they are. Here we go.
For the queen!
Interpreting vague answer as yes. So here we go. For 2,000 bits, here's your next question. All right, here we go. And it ain't easy being breezies. Is it? There we go. Yeah, because the music is kind of quieter here. And it ain't easy being breezies. What was the cheer Fluttershy taught the main six? Was it A, go breezies go, B, don't stop, C, you can do it, breezies, or D, breezies are best pony?
You can do it, breezies.
All right, final answer?
Yes.
Checking my answer key. No, I don't need to check the answer key. I know it's right, and I know you're right. All right, so here we go. You've got, that was question number 6 of 15, so you're not halfway through, but you're almost halfway through. And next question. 4,000 bits by J.S. Josh. Yes. What is the longest MLP fanfiction?
You've got to be kidding me.
A, My Little Dashy. B, Fallout Equestria. C, Past Sins. Or D, Cupcakes.
I'm gonna go ahead and use 50-50 on this one.
Alright, computer, please take away 2 of the wrong answers, leaving only 1 wrong answer and the correct answer. You're left with Fallout Equestria or Past Sins.
Okay, that's an easy one. B, please.
Final answer?
Yep.
Okay, which one were you thinking? Mild Dashy or Cup? Oh, you got it right as well. Okay, but now I'm curious. Which one were you thinking of?
Well, yeah. I don't read fanfiction, so I wouldn't know.
Okay.
But I know Fallout Equestria is really, really long, and I've never heard of Past Sins ever. So.
Awesome.
Neat.
Pretty good.
All right.
Again, I don't read
fanfiction,
I wouldn't know.
Opinions I don't like.
Yeah, he just poked at his door, he was like, that's horrible. Okay, here we go, for 8,000 bits, here's your next question. Alright, yeah, we're getting there, I believe. Yeah, no, wait, hold on, 2,000, 4,000, 8,000. Yes, this is the halfway point, if you get this one right. Who was the voice of... Oh, it's pretty obvious here. Who was the voice of Cheese Sandwich and Pinkie Pride? Well, now I want to see what the answers are. A, Peter New. B, Rena Chan, of course. C, Weird Al Yankovic, oh boy. Or D, Justin Bieber.
Oh, God.
That was true, I'd put the fan
A lot of us would.
Let's go with C.
Weird Al Yankovic, final answer?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, can you imagine Justin Bieber?
I can see him as a breezy.
Well, yeah. They don't even have to alter his voice or anything.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, right. Yeah.
Fun fact, he's actually nondescript background pony number 358.
Alright. Well, at least he has...
Fandom.
Well... Okay, bye.
I am successful.
Don't forget to visit the gift shop on your way out.
One down, 600 million to go.
We're doing it. We're making progress here. Okay, I believe now for 16,000 bits, here's your next question. We're getting close to that second prize. In fact, it'll actually be the question after this for your opportunity to get that second prize. In the Find a Pet song, what was the last animal listed? A, a squirrel, B, a bat, C, a flamingo, or D, an eagle?
Oh, boy.
You can sing the song if you want to.
It's not bad. I'm gonna have to use the Skype thing.
Alright, so now we bring up my glorious menu of Skype. There we go. Glorious menu of Skype contacts. So any of those with a green dot on them, you can call any of them.
Ooh, Tomb Critic. I know this guy. Yeah, let's go with him.
Alright, so let's go ahead and turn down our volume here so we'll be able to hear him. And here we go. Now, how do I get this on speaker? Here we go.
Is that the best thing you've got for speaker? That's actually pretty cool.
I'm just dancing.
Are you sure he's on? I'm pretty sure he had an interview with Golden Vox or something.
Well, he said he'd be available.
No.
Okay, I guess not.
Can I just use 50-50 instead?
No, you can't, because we already used that. So it's up. Oh, wait, here we go. Really sorry, man. XD. Okay. So who else would you like to choose?
So he's not available.
No.
Well, I kind of know Keyframe.
You want to do that?
Sure.
All right, let's try this again, and I think we're going to be dancing again, maybe. I don't know. Push the speakerphone button.
Here we go. This is ridiculous.
We need someone to like remix this.
I'll try.
Let's get like Mike the microphone or someone on this. Come on.
You're doing a good job filling up that hole after 45 minutes.
Yeah. I actually now have 30 minutes to fill. 27 minutes.
Your friends aren't very reliable.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. All right. Well, let's try this.
We should try Tune Critic again just to really bug him.
All right. Let's do this. Because we can.
Did he just flat out said no? Are you sure I can't just log on with my Skype contacts? I'm pretty sure mine are a bit more reliable.
Well, hey, there's like six other ones there.
But three of them don't have the green lights.
Well, welcome to my little Skype call. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna choose the person now. Okay, wait, who sent me a message? I can't, man. Sorry, didn't realize it would be this early.
I wanted
a later panel.
Call again.
We've got 30 minutes. Okay, no. Let's do someone else. It seems to be just those four, minus Cider Barrel. I think the other four are actually waiting for a call, to be honest.
You know, but Brony.
Alright, let's go ahead and call Unova Brony. Now I know this guy on a personal level, and he should answer. Let's get ready to dance again.
I was really looking forward to talking to you, Tim Critic. You shattered my dreams.
It's not my fault.
Where's the music?
Hello?
Yeah?
Oh, we finally got someone. Hold on, let me plug you into the speakers here. We finally got someone. Ladies and gentlemen, we got Unova Brony. All right, well, So, this is Unova Brony, correct? It's not Two and Critic playing a prank on us.
No, it's not, Bobby. It's Unova Brony.
Okay, I'm actually going by my real name in this one. My online name is like Bobby. Don't ask, long story. So, we have somebody here who needs your help with a question. It's been a while. We tried to contact Toon Craig and Keyframe a lot, but it wasn't
working.
Three times. Yeah, three times. So, I actually have to go back and look at the question here. Alright, so, he needs your help to answer a question. So, you know, to read the question and answers off to him, and you will have three. Okay, memorize the answers. You got them? Squirrel, bat, flamingo, or do you want me to do it? I can remember the answers.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. So, you will have 30 seconds, and here we go.
In the Find a Pet song, what was the last pet mentioned? A flamingo, a squirrel, a bat, or an eagle?
Okay.
15 seconds.
I would have to say a flamingo.
Flamingo?
You're sure?
Flamingo. I am definitely sure.
I appreciate it.
Okay, you have 4 seconds. Anyone you want to say hi to?
I would definitely...
Perfect timing. Sorry, Unova. Didn't fit in the time.
You sick jerk.
Alright, so... Hey, he has exactly 30 seconds. So he said... Okay, there we go. So he said flamingo. Is that what you're going with?
Yes.
I forgot to ask final answer. I'm supposing that it is?
Well, yeah.
Okay. He's correct. We went through all of that, and you got it. All right, so you know what this means. Next question, if you get it right, then you get the next prize. So here we go. For 32,000 bits, here's your next question. We probably could have taken a commercial through all of that Skype nonsense.
Oh, boy.
Okay, here we go. By J.S. Josh. Which of these songs has not become a Brony Dance Party PMV?
Piece of cake.
A, Beyond Her Garden. B, Awoken. C, Nightmare Night. Or D, 20% Cooler.
I'm subscribed to this guy and I'm a huge fan. 20% Cooler!
Okay, hold on, wait. Which question is this? 6, 7, okay, no. 2000, 4000, 2,000, 4,000, 8,000,
16,000, 32,000.
Okay. Final answer?
D. Final answer.
It was Beyond Her Garden. I can't actually remember.
You said not.
Wait a minute.
You said no. Beyond Her Garden is a PMV.
Yeah.
Well, hey, guess what? Don't blame me. Blame that guy. He sent in the question. Let's do some research here. I've got 20 minutes to fill. We can do some research.
I followed this guy actively and I've never seen 20% Cooler on
his... It's his first TMV!
That's probably why. Beyond Our Garden's there too, though.
Yeah, it is. I've seen it.
So, what do we... Okay, you know what? No, just... Because we don't know, just... You got it!
Yay!
I will have to correct that. So, good job, Josh. Good job. We had controversy over that. So, hey, look, you got the next prize, and now I get to grab it while you get to listen to me telling you what the prize is. Let's turn this down because it is a little loud.
Congratulations, you've won a My Little Pony collectible vinyl figure. Direct from the host's personal collection, you can choose to get either Vinyl Scratch or Rainbow Dash. These 5.5-inch vinyl figures are sculpted based on My Little Pony characters, and they're sure to make any part of your house at least 20% cooler. From Funko!
Did I really just say that? Yeah. Alright, so, and since you're the last contestant of the show, so you have your choice. Which one do you want?
I can't have both.
Unfortunately, you can only have one. That's what it said there.
Fine. Final
scratch. Alright, there you go. It is yours, my friend. So congratulations on that. We just passed 5 questions. Commercial!
Yay!
We'll be back after a word from our sponsors. Let's try calling Toon Critic.
Yes!
Okay.
Because we've got 2 minutes here. No, wait, he just sent me a message. What is he saying? Hope the guy wins.
Call him again!
Call him again!
Call him again!
I want to schedule an interview with this guy.
Anybody else have someone? Let's call him.
There you go! This is what happens during commercials. No, let's do this. Get high quality version of this.
Everyone conga! Bum, 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 bum. Dance! It is the forbidden dance!
Okay, I'm gonna tell him the audience is trying to annoy you. Sorry, I can't control their actions.
Munt.
Violence, that helps.
Oh my. Hey, this is a kids program here. We have children. They're coloring. Oh my gosh, that's so cute.
I have an announcement.
Okay. LOL, no problem. Give me a second. You have 30 seconds. Okay, call. We're actually getting him.
Yes.
Bum, 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 bum.
Okay, so sorry about that.
We finally got you! Yay! Oh my gosh. Okay, well luckily we're in a commercial break. They just wanted to call you just because they wanted to annoy you.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah,
we're trolls!
Yep, they are professional trolls.
Nobody controlled by
the Hey, tune credit, can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, I can hear you guys.
Alright, well first off, I did get the question right.
Ask me that question.
Second off, I actually have my own review YouTube channel. What was my name on YouTube? It's ACTBP. Look me up, I would like to do a collab.
ACTP.
You're probably busy though, but I would like to do one anyway.
Wait, hold on, what was that? Say that again.
Sure, why not? I'll usually collab with just about anybody.
Alright, he got the collab! Yay! Oh boy, here comes the Ponyville Live executive. They're gonna take up the camera. Let's go.
Music.
This is not going well. I'm not professional here in this job. It may seem like it, but I'm not. Welcome back, everyone. Skip the songs because we don't have time. This is the walk away button. Basically what happens, you click it, you walk away with the amount earned from the previous question. Here we go, 64,000 bits, here's your next question. You know the Brony, skip that. In the MLPCCG, which set did Princess Celestia and Princess Luna come out as main characters? A, Rockin' Rave, B, Royal Rumble, C, Canterlot Knights, or D, Rainbow Dash and Rarity Theme Deck?
That one is death. No, wait.
Okay.
If I get this wrong, I deserve to give up all of my prizes. Don't quote me on that.
Well, no, you get to keep them. That's a
okay. Well, that question. Let's go with Canterlot Knights.
Final answer.
Yes.
2 seconds pause because we have to. You're correct. He's getting so close. Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead. Just get myself ready. Let's go ahead and pull out this box of confetti.
I used to work at a card shop, so if I get this, I do not deserve any.
And I do apologize if I do have to toss this. I do ask none of you pick it up because I have to use this again. And don't worry, I will clean it. Okay, here we go. How much? Whatever amount. Next question. 125,000. Buy trouble notes. Who was wearing number 88 in the Running of the Leaves during the episode Fall Weather Friends? A, Lyra Heartstrings, B, Golden Harvest, C, Shoeshine, or D, Berry Punch?
I'm not risking anything if I get this wrong, right? Or my prizes anyway?
No.
YOLO, Lyra Heartstrings.
Final answer?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Her, Berry Punch.
The good news is I don't have to do this. There we go. Alright, well, good job to both of you. If you want to come back up here, you can. Because we have to end out the show now. Oh yeah, you did not get money because I do not have money. Okay, but anyways, congratulations to... Alright, we have to do a song. Congratulations to both. Skip that. Congratulations to both of you for playing. And where is... I've got my secret box here. So congratulations to both of you all for playing. And thank you all for coming. Enjoy the rest of your day at Brony Fan Fair. Roll credits. We're done here. I just realized I have to clean all this up. Come on.